Hello students, welcome to my video number 32. Here in this video I am going to discuss question answers of this poem that we have done already. Now let us see what questions are given here. We have two different headings of question. One is an extract based question and another we have another set of questions which are long answer type. So let us begin with this extract based given here. First, we see the extract. The extract is, some water, coal and oil is all we ask and the thousandth of an inch to give us play. Now, this is the extract for the first question is, who is we in these lines? Now, we all know, we here are the machines. Second question, why do they need water, coal and oil? Now, those who have seen the explanation nicely will be able to make out that water, coal and oil are the fuels that are required by the machines to function, to perform their task. So, this water, coal and oil are needed for by the machines to perform their task, to keep running, to keep doing their job. Next one, what do they mean by to give us play? To give us play means these fuels they need to get started. Once they get the fuel like water, coal or oil, they get started to perform their task. So that will write here. Next we have under question B, six questions are given. Let us see one by one. The first question, what is the nine-decked city? Now we remember the nine-decked city is the ship that is mentioned in the poem, Mauritania, the largest, the biggest luxury ship of that time. And this nine-decked city is the other name of this Mauritania. Next one, the second part of the same question is, why is it described as monstrous? It is described as monstrous because because of the size. It was the largest passenger ship of that time. That is why it is given being described here as monstrous. That is as big as a monster. Next one, which stanza shows us that the machines have mastered almost all the common human activities? Now, we know which stanza, of course, the second stanza where it is talking about all the different functions that it performs. We can pull and howl and push and lift and drive, we can print and plow and weave and heat and light, we can run and race and swim and fly and dive, we can see and hear and count and read and write. So what we see, most of the functions that a machine performs are all mentioned here. So you will write down this stanza in this second answer. Question number 3. What actions are the machines incapable of doing? We know which actions they are incapable of doing. It's given here in the second last stanza that they are incapable of detecting a lie. They cannot understand or they cannot detect a lie. And another thing we maybe come to know about machines is that they are feelingless and emotionless things. They do not have feelings like love, pity or forgive. So this is something which is not there in machines. They are incapable of these things. You will mention these. Next, let us see question number 4. Which lines tell us that for very little input, the machines are able to provide constant daily service to humans? Now, which lines tell us that very little input they need and they are capable of providing constant, that is continuous daily service to humans? Of course, this is given here in the first stanza, the last four lines. Some water, coal and oil is all we ask. Input means these fuels, the fuels that they use for functioning, for working. And then they keep on providing service to us 24 hours. So we'll mention this last four lines of the first stanza in this answer. Next one, question number 5. Which two opposing claims do the machines make in the poem? opposing claims, that is two opposite claims. Let us find the lines here. In the last line of the second last stanza, we are everything on earth except gods. This line here, we are everything on earth except gods. This is opposing claim, that is, it is opposite to each other. Everything on earth, but there is an exception except the gods. And another we see here, last line of the poem, we are nothing more than children of your brain. Again, it is claiming that we are nothing more than children of your brain. These two lines can be written in this answer number 5. Next one, question number 6 is given here. Which lines tell us that the all-powerful nature of the machines is only an illusion? Now, the ones who have listened to the explanation in the video will be easily able to make out which lines speak about that the machines are the function, the task that they perform, and the dependency on the machines is actually an illusion. So what will be the answer? Of course, this last stanza, though our smoke may hide the heavens from your eyes, it will vanish and the stars will shine again, because for all our power and weight and size, we are nothing more than children of your brain. So here it is accepting the fact that whatever the power and weight and size of the machines are, they are ultimately dependent on human being to make them function, to make them work. Unless anybody is not there to operate these machines, they won't function. So that is what it is, and it is just an illusion, the kind of all-powerful nature of the machines is just an illusion. This you will mention here. So this much here, the 4-6 questions we have. But apart from these, I will be uploading some extra questions in the assignment section. You will have to complete those also. And here, this part given about the different stanzas known by different names depending upon the number of lines they have. You will have to learn these and will have to answer this question given in the end here. What is the stanzaic pattern of the poem you just read? So after doing this, reading this, going through it, you will be answering this. So now let me tell you what are the different things you are going to write in the copy. First, you will write the name of the lesson. Then you will draw some machines that can be of your choice, or you can take the examples given here. So any two or three machines or any one machine also you can draw here, and then write a short summary of the poem. After that, you will write down the word meanings given here as we did in our previous lessons. After that, you will continue with the question answers, and then this part also. So this much for today. God bless you all and take care, everyone.